It refers to an incident about a shepherd. A shepherd who was also a prophet. A prophet who was Kalimullah, the one whom Allah spoke to. Of course, Musa alayhi salam. And here Allah engages Musa in a dialogue. Allah says to him, وَمَا تِلْكَ بِيَمِينِكَ يَا مُوسَى. What is in your hand, in your right hand, O Musa? Just by the way, etiquette. Note the tone with which Allah addresses Musa. He doesn't say, Musa, what is in your hand? He says, what is in your hand, O Musa? Just the way the question is phrased indicates a degree of endearment and respect. What is in your hand, O Musa? And Musa alayhi salam replied, قَالَ هِيَ عَصَايِ. It is a stick, a staff. أَتَوَكَّوْ عَلَيْهَا وَأَهُشُّ بِهَا عَلَىٰ غَنَمِي وَلِيَ فِيهَا مَآرِبُ أُخْرَىٰ. It's a staff, sometimes I lean on it, and sometimes I thresh the bushes so that my sheep may go and eat the shrubs, and I also have other uses for it. Allah then says to him, قَالَ أَلْقِهَا يَا مُوسَىٰ. Throw it down, O Musa. فَأَلْقَاهَا. He threw it down, فَإِذَا هِيَ حَيَّةٌ تَسْعَىٰ. That lifeless piece of wood became a moving serpent. Just there. Story is long, lot of dimensions, just that part. What are the lessons we learn from that? Only that. A stick or a staff, when found laying on the ground somewhere, no one would be interested in it. No one would desire to possess it or fight over it. But nonetheless, that lifeless piece of wood, like when we die, in this world we have life, that piece of wood was once a part of a living branch of a breathing tree. It bore leaves, it had fruits and flowers, it provided sustenance and shelter for those who sought its shade, but also, once it's cut away from the tree, it was rendered lifeless, but not necessarily worthless. This is the staff, not insignificant by the way. There's many uses, and Musa alayhi salam mentioned some. I lean on it. I clear the path with it. But you can also defend yourself with it. You can beat off danger with it. Make fire to provide heat or energy with it. You can guide. It's a guide for the blind to identify their surroundings and to detect their way. It's a means of preventing injury when going through rugged or harsh terrain. It helps you when you're climbing up a hill or down a mountain. It can knock a fruit from a tree which is far to reach, so that you may eat from it. When Musa alayhi salam is asked about the staff, he says, what he does with it? I lean on it and I use it for my sheep and cattle, for my sheep to break the way through the bushes for them to eat. And then I have other uses for it. But it was also his vocation. It was the instrument that he used for his living. So it's more than just a simple shepherd's staff. It was a personal tool for Musa alayhi salam, and more importantly, it represented his labor, it represented his life, it represented his livelihood. Now, Allah showed Musa alayhi salam, and all of us, through Musa and the story of the staff, or the incident of the staff, that being connected to Allah can make you reach beyond the ordinary. Being connected to Allah can make you reach beyond the ordinary. This is what you call the significance of association. The significance of association. To use another example or simile, the raindrop from the sky, if it's caught in your hands, pure water to drink. Most nourishing water to drink. The liquid of life. If that same drops of water falls in a filthy gutter, it's not worthy of washing your feet with it. That same drop of water, if it falls on a boiling surface, it evaporates and perishes. If it falls on ice, it becomes frozen. If it falls on a leaf, it shines like a diamond. And if it falls into an oyster, it can become a pearl. It depends with what that drop becomes associated. That same drop, its existence and worth depends on what and with whom it associates itself. Therefore, the staff of Musa alayhi salam, basic, seemingly insignificant piece of wood, an instrument of Musa alayhi salam, which he uses for his work as a shepherd. Yet, it could outdo the machinations of the magicians eventually, and even defeat the power of the Pharaoh. This stick, when thrown by Musa alayhi salam, turned into a serpent, and overcame the snakes of the magicians. He struck the rock later on in the Quran, the rocks, and water flowed from it. And also, he struck it onto the water, and the sea opened up. All that with the same stick. At the same time, we learn, Allah, the Lord of the heavens and the earth, is also the Lord of the dead wood. He was also the Lord, and he's the Lord of the tree, the living tree from which this branch came before it became dead wood. And all things are subject to Allah's commands. The staff of Musa transformed into a snake, and back into a staff. It caused the Red Sea to part, or whichever water it was. But it was only a staff in Musa's hand, but it could defeat and paralyze an enemy. But the power does not lie in the staff itself. It's rather with Allah, the Creator, who gave everything the ability and capacity. One of the important things we learn from this as well is the paradigm shift. When Allah asked Musa, what is in your hand? Allah knew, of course Allah knew, better than Musa alayhi salam. To make him realize what you feel you can do with it, and when I'm busy with you, what I can make you do with it. You look after the sheep, you find the way, you lean on it, I can make you bring down an empire with a stick. So Allah changed Musa alayhi salam's paradigm about the way he looked at his staff. Allah was transforming his view of that stick, that staff, which was his vocation. No longer was it a simple tool of Musa in his hand, it was now a representative power and a symbol of authority. A key component in the life of Musa. If you look at the life of Musa, his brother Harun is involved, there's Khidr alayhi salam involved, there's a Pharaoh involved, and there's a stick involved. It's part of the life and the story of Musa. It's one of the important characters in the life of Musa alayhi salam. The question we need to realize, what is our stick? What is our staff? What is our hidden skill? What is our unknown talent which we are not bringing forth? We can use our potential. Each one has a potential. And we learn from this Musa alayhi salam story, maximize your skill even if it is a piece of dead wood. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.